It feels fantastic understanding what Bitcoin is, owning Bitcoin, seeing things like what we're about to go over in this video. Breaking news, 10,000 Bitcoin has just been taken off the market. 10,000 Bitcoin has just been added to Stone Ridge's balance sheet. In today's video, that's what I want to talk about. I also want to go over, I want to check in with some of our favorite analysts, see what they have to say. We'll go over world news. Maybe we'll even have time to go over the whole market. Guys, like the video, support the channel. Do you want to read this story on CoinDesk or do you want to read this story on Forbes? You know what? Let's start with CoinDesk. Stone Ridge calls its 114 million Bitcoin its primary treasury reserve asset. Stone Ridge Holding Group is stashing 10,000 Bitcoin, adding to its balance sheet. So surely we'll be able to find Stone Ridge on this list. We see some of our favorites, MicroStrategies, Square. This list is only getting bigger, but I don't see Stone Ridge. It is because Stone Ridge, unlike these companies, is not a publicly traded company. It's not a publicly traded company. Publicly traded companies have to disclose their holdings. Stone Ridge is choosing to. The private firm called Bitcoin its new primary treasury reserve asset. This language first adopted by MicroStrategies. So people are starting to take notice what other people are doing. Now, I liked the story that Forbes did. Before we get to some of these other charts and graphs, I like how Forbes told the story of Stone Ridge because they go through Stone Ridge's three-year journey into Bitcoin. So check this out. In just a couple paragraphs, we'll find out why Stone Ridge is so bullish or how they got into it. 3 years ago, the founders of the $10 billion Stone Ridge Asset Management, they had a problem. Several of the advisory firm's founders and senior employees were buying Bitcoin at such a rate, it became obvious the purchase needed to be looked at more closely by the firm's auditors. As word got out that Stone Ridge's staff was personally investing in Bitcoin, this was years ago, it happened at such a scale, they were talking about it so much, the firm's clients increasingly wanted to express the same thesis. As Stone Ridge co-founder put it, that thesis is the belief in the long-term growth of an open-source monetary system in assets like Bitcoin. Now, the problem is that Stone Ridge needed a way to turn the dollars that they wanted to invest into Bitcoin and to safely store Bitcoin once they had it. And since they were personally invested in Bitcoin also, they needed to do all that in a way that not only satisfied their clients, auditors, and regulators, but themselves. So instead of just establishing a few custom funds for their clients, Stone Ridge took the extraordinary steps of building execution and custody tools from scratch and kicking off an entirely new line of revenue. So this has all been happening over the past few years, executing cryptocurrency purchases and then holding onto the asset for their customers. Now, by 2017, that vision had evolved into the New York Digital Investment Group, NYDIG, the first Stone Ridge subsidiary that isn't wholly owned by the parent company. And that firm quietly raised $50 million. Well, cut to today, Stone Ridge Holding Group revealed that NYDIG is custodying 10,000 of the parent company's Bitcoin valued at $115 million in today's price. People are starting to take notice. Now, let's check in with some of our favorite analysts. People are getting increasingly bullish on Bitcoin. This is Will Reeves. Hey, he follows me. Will Reeves is the Fold CEO. Fold is a great Bitcoin company. I use the app all the time, especially when I go to Chipotle. He says, in the last few weeks alone, I've spoken to top wealth and investment managers with several trillion under management. This is just the beginning. Let's check in with Bit Harrington. Gives good perspective. Bitcoin went from $1 to $10 to $100 to $1,000 to $10,000. Buy the dip below $10,000, just like everybody was hoping to buy Bitcoin below $1,000, just like everybody was hoping to buy Bitcoin below $110,000. Will we ever see a $10,000 Bitcoin again? Or a less than $10,000 Bitcoin again? I don't know, because as he points out, this is happening right now. Bitcoin getting bullish. Nobody noticing anything except us. Bullish AF. Now let's check in with Bob Lucas, who is one of my favorite analysts popularizing the four-year journey. Hey, follows me. Nice. The foundation for the next Bitcoin four-year cycle rally has been poured and now is set. Institutional custody, accumulation, acceptance, and time. Only those who are impatient, greedy, and driven by emotion stand to lose out. So as you recall, myself and Bob Lucas, actually Bob Lucas released his first video talking about the four-year journey right around the bottom. And it's been playing out beautifully so far. Now, I'm sure this chart is just more of, not specific because you can't really call tops. But, you know, according to this chart, he sees Bitcoin possibly topping out at just under $400,000. It will soon be very widely understood that not owning Bitcoin is financially irresponsible. I agree. I like that. Let's get to some world news before we get to, this is pretty interesting, but let's get to the China news. China hands out 1.5 million of its digital currency in one of the country's biggest public tests. The reason I bring this up is because you can see the way that nation states, global powers, governments, you can see what they're doing. They're going to want you on their permissioned system. We're going to need a currency that is decentralized, permissionless, undebatable. We are going to need Bitcoin. Now, how did they get the people of China to get on their system? Well, they carried out a lottery to give away a total of 10 million yen, about 1.5 million worth of its digital currency. And the winners had to download the app. The digital yen is not a cryptocurrency like Bitcoin. Instead, it is issued and controlled by the People's Bank of China, the country's central bank. Oh, it's the People's Bank. Well, that's good. This is so interesting. There's now a literal shitcoin to track San Francisco's street poop. This is an ERC-20 token. Poop token may only be half serious, but San Francisco's public defecation problem is no joke. San Francisco is in the midst of a looming public health crisis due to public defecation. Naturally, somebody has created an ERC token to address the problem. The digital asset called Poop Token comes courtesy of the Universal Market Access Protocol, UMA team. The idea was formulated by Daniel Q and Tyson B, both of Coinbase, and then developed by Hart L and others at last week's ETH Waterloo Hackathon. So this was created using UMA's synthetic token builder. Poop Token tracks the number of feces sightings in San Francisco using an official city database. So check out the tokenomics. The token's price goes up with the number of sightings and goes down as the city gets cleaner. It's available for purchase on Uniswap. Huh, not Coinbase. Now, of course, the problem is the immediate question, doesn't this actually create an incentive to make the city less hygienic? And one of the creators said, it is possible that this shitcoin could create an economic incentive for a large bag holder to promote public shittings and actually make the problem worse. He thinks laws and social mores would stop this from happening. But the story goes on to say that San Francisco says they will not be harassing homeless people, so they might not be enforcing if people are pooping on the street. One of the final stories of today, where is it? Serena Williams looks to have dropped her Coinbase investment. Huh, that's interesting. Tennis superstar and investor Serena Williams may have shed her stake in popular US-based cryptocurrency exchange Coinbase, as reported by Business Insider late on Monday. The website of Williams' venture firm no longer displays Coinbase among its portfolio firms. Now, Serena Williams, a company launched in secret, Serena Ventures, a company launched in secret in 2014, first listed the investment in Coinbase in April of last year. Also, Williams tweeted about the investment at the time. Maybe she's becoming a maximalist. Maybe she's becoming a no-coiner. I don't know. I would think that if you invested in Coinbase last year, it only looks better today. I think Coinbase is going to do well in these next couple years. Hey, Charlie Lee tweeted something. What is it? Holy hell. Happy birthday, Litecoin. Happy birthday. Happy ninth birthday. And then finally, wanted to point this out. A friend of mine has spent 10,000 printing a million of these bad boys. Which one is your favorite? Let me know down below. Right now, Bitcoin's price is 11,390. That is all for me today, ladies and gentlemen. Let me know if you think this story is as big and as exciting as I think it is.
When you're acting in love, you're like a drop of water and you have the ocean as your army. When you act in fear, It's just you and your money. Mm. Now, you could take your money and put it in Bitcoin, put a credit form, put it in cash, or all your cash in this, and then stand up to the ocean, and who's going to win? We definitely are dealing with racism, but I want to push future concepts. You know, now I'm giving you two streams of consciousness in one. I want to talk about my wife. I also want to talk about Harriet Tubman on a $20 bill.
We're following you. We're following you all. You set it up good.
Okay. That was the moment that I wanted to use Bitcoin, and I saw Harriet Tubman on a $20 bill.